All right, guys, today we are going to try to replicate something that I created by accident, which was this cup. I was trying to do a technique called the marble ink technique that I saw in a Tumblr group, and it was not going how I wanted it to go. You use alcohol inks to create it, and so I was trying to fix it, I guess, and I ended up making this on accident, but I really liked it, so I kept with it and added some gold foil, some glitter into the epoxy, and I think it turned out pretty cool. A lot of people liked it, some asked for tutorials, so I thought I would try again and see if I could replicate it. For this one, I used several different alcohol inks that I didn't grab. Maybe I'll try to grab that in a second. But I used the rose gold foil from the Glitter Craze. But I think for the one I'm going to do today, I'm going to try to use just the regular gold foil, also from Glitter Craze. The glitter that I put into the epoxy coat, was Pink Opal by Glitter Glams, and that gave it a really pretty sparkle. So, the inks that I'm going to try to use today are going to be Tim Holtz Sailboat Blue, Indigo, Pool, Pistachio, which I also used that on the other cup, Piñata in Passion Purple, and then Tim Holtz again in Cranberry. I was trying to go with more gem tones. So you're going to need your alcohol inks, whatever colors you prefer, some these are just makeup sponges, and I actually like to cut some of the edges off so that when you're dabbing your cup, it's not leaving such a rigid square. So I do end up doing that to my sponges so it's not so blunt. I do have some alcohol in a cup to dip my sponge into. When I'm all finished, I do end up spraying my cup again with 91% alcohol. I'm going to put gloves on though this time because my hands did get very messy the last time. So for the basis of the other cup that I did, the tutorial that I was following, she basically covered the entire cup with a light color to lay down a base color. So that's what I'm going to do. This is just a prepped and primed spray painted white tumbler. And I think I'm going to use Sailboat Blue, and we'll see what that shows up as. Again, don't worry about being perfect. This is just to give it a base coat. You're going to go over it many times with more layers, and then at the very end, you're going to spray it down with alcohol anyway. So, I'm going to dip it into my alcohol. base coat is down. This just helps it to get rid of all that bright white. So what you're gonna do is just pick a color you wanna start with. Let's see how cranberry looks, because I wasn't really sure about this choice. So let's see if I'm gonna actually go with it. And in this one, I was trying to make marble-like lines. So it was kind of like this, and you'd let it spread out a second, and then you would just kind of dab. Of course, this is a dark color. I was using more pastels on that one. But I think since I'm really just going to spray this and they're gonna all blend and flow together, I don't think that it really is gonna matter that much. So I'm just going to apply the color in sections, kind of in a geode design maybe. Maybe have the color a little bit heavier in certain areas. Like I did on the other cup, so that maybe the end result will be similar. We will see how this turns out. And if it doesn't, then at least it's just alcohol ink and we can take it all off and start over. Okay, so it's pretty much colored everywhere. It has a lot of heavy lines of ink all over. This did not take near as long as when I attempted to do the original technique of the marble ink of the first cup. This is not how it looked. It did look better than this, but it didn't look how I wanted it to, and I was frustrated. So, what I started doing was just spraying the cup with alcohol. Letting the colors run. So I'm gonna try to do this without making a total mess. First, I just kind of did it everywhere, and it's gonna look odd at first, kind of speckled. And you'll get a little run. Then I went a little bit heavier, kind of at the top, so that it would flow down like that. I hope you can see the angle of my hand is kind of. And I would kind of lean the cup so that it would flow if I wanted it to go in any particular direction. And I turned it upside down. And then kind of ran back down. I think I even used my heat gun a little bit just to speed up the alcohol drying. I like it. I may dab a little bit more, play around with it a little bit more, but that's essentially it. I'll come back and show you how I added the gold foil, and then I'll just epoxy, and that will be that. It's a pretty cool cup, and just it's like a melted, I don't know, acid marble. It's really pretty. It's different, and no two will look alike, that is for sure. Okay, I'll come back in a little bit, or maybe tomorrow, actually it's late, and do the foil part for you. Okay, we are back for the foil part of the cup. I did go back after I cut off the video, and I dabbed a little bit more of the color with the sponge. I didn't spray anymore, I don't think, but this is how it ended up. I like it. I have already laid out some foil pieces. Again, this is from the Glitter Craze. It's just gold foil. Sometimes they come in really large chunks, and I don't want it that big, so I've had to tear them. And I apply it with Mod Podge and some tweezers. And so last time I wasn't really prepared, so I thought maybe tearing it ahead of time might be a little bit better. And they do fly away easy. So I did grab the alcohol ink colors that I used on this cup in case anyone wanted to know those shades. And they were Tim Holtz Cloudy Blue, and that was the color that I used as the all-over base color too. I used Wow Plum, Purple Twilight, Indigo, and then Pistachio. So those were the shades that I used on the first cup. Okay, so I just have some Mod Podge in a little medicine cup, a paintbrush, some tweezers, and let's get started. I don't have any rhyme or reason to where I apply this. On this other cup, I just kind of followed some of the veins, if you will. Some of them weren't put on anything, just empty space, just until I liked how it looked. And also, this is a good way to hide if there's an area that you don't particularly like, maybe a line that you don't like how it dried or it ended up. You can kind of cover that with a foil too. So let's see. Particularly a fan of that section. Alexa, next. Can you see I'm going back and I'm trying to lay all the little pieces down? I do go back and spray this with a clear sealer before I epoxy to help it not move when I'm applying the epoxy. But some little pieces still did move. So the better it's adhered to the cup, the less pieces will float away during the epoxy stage. So as you're going along, if you angle the cup, I don't even know if you can see this on the video, at a side, you can see the pieces of the foil that's lifted up. So that's what you're going to want to press down with your Mod Podge to make sure that it'll stay down when you epoxy. All right, so what do we think? You have to be careful not to touch it because you'll pull the foil right off, which I've done several times already. So I'm gonna let this dry and spray it with some clear sealer, and then I will put some epoxy on it. I don't know that I'm gonna use the same glitter. I may choose a different one with a different tone to it. This is kind of a pink opal to it. Obviously it's called pink opal, but I may go with a different one for this. I will let you know what I choose. I'm gonna clean all this foil up. Okay, so here it is, with epoxy on it. I think it turned out pretty rad. I'm gonna call this the melted marble technique. And this glitter is really pretty. It's Crew Juice by Mr. Nola's Glitter. I'll show you the bottle in just a second. All right, so that's the glitter that I mixed into the epoxy this time. It's not quite as fine as the pink opal that I mixed for the first cup, but it's still really pretty. Let's see. Right, so we'll hold them both together. And these are both tumblers from the Stainless Steel Depot. This is a 32 ounce slim, and the one that I did on the video is a 22 ounce slim. Very pretty. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and you can make one of these melted marble tumblers for yourself.